I'm Matt Pinfield. With me now is Ed Simmons and Tom Rollins of the Chemical Brothers. Good to have you guys here. Yeah. Thanks for coming out and visiting us during your tour.
Pleasure to be here.
Yeah. Now, you're from London originally, but you two met in Manchester. You were going to school there?
Yeah, college, yeah.
And you were really involved, were you both fans of the like Deep House and Acid House scene?
That's cool. We both went to study history there, and then one of the reasons we went there was to see the Hacienda and go to the Hacienda and stuff, so it's quite a cool time. And also you had the Stone Roses and like Happy Mondays and people.
New Order.
Yeah, New Order, of course, those guys co-owned the club, right? So
it was a nice place to be in like 1989. It was like very good.
Yeah, it was right around that time of Fool's Gold. It was actually right number one right at the end of the year that time. And things were really starting to come to a head.
Yeah, definitely.
Mondays
with
the Step On and Pills, Thrills was their big album that year. But that was a whole scene was
exciting
going.
Times.
Yeah, there were some great records too. Yeah,
absolutely.
And speaking of which, we're going to actually, you end up working with some of the artists from that area. What we're going to do is we're going to come back and talk more about the history of the Chemical Brothers, but let's talk about the video for Setting Sun. It's an amazing piece of work. Now, you got two guys' first names credited for doing the video. Are they friends here? Tell me a bit about them.
Two guys called Dom and Nick.
Yeah.
We just seen their stuff they've done. Who they done stuff for?
Supergrass and Blue Tones. They just thought they're quite witty, you know, visually. They're just sort of young, like us as well, and just sort of having a go, so just gave them a chance, and I think it looks pretty cool. Yeah.
It gives you a real tripped out feeling when you're watching it, like, you know, you're...
It kind of gets pretty twisted towards the middle.
And all the craziness, and when it goes into that sound break, that one synth break, and the cops dancing. Well, let's let everybody check it out. Right now we're going to play the Chemical Brothers' latest video. Here's Setting Sun.
Thank you.
120 minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield. I'm sitting here with the Chemical Brothers. Now, you're originally in bands. Were you playing traditional instruments? I'd heard you were in some other bands playing guitars and drums.
I used to be in a group. I had a guitarist, but in that group, I used to do like all the sampling and the beats and the sequencing and stuff. But I can play the guitar and all that business.
Yeah. Now, you guys, let's talk about "Song to a Siren," the first single that you did. How was that received over there when that first came down?
It came out at a time when it was our club scene was kind of chance dominated, you know, sort of 130 BPM, so it was really different, and that's why it sort of got attention, I suppose, because using breaks and stuff and the weird sounds we've got in that record, so it was, you know, caught a lot of people's attention at the time, you know.
Yeah. Now, Exoplanet Dust, is that the title to your debut album?
Yeah.
Is that referring to the fact that you were called the Dust Brothers originally? And there's the Dust Brothers here in America who produced Beastie Boys and Beck. What ended up going down with that whole thing? Was that something where somebody said, oh, you know, there's already Dust Brothers, or did you get like a legal notice?
They just got in touch with us and said that it was their name, and they said, would you change it? And we said, yeah, we will change it. It's your name. So.
We had the name, and we were just DJing in Manchester, so we never thought it was going to be a problem. It was only when we put out records that came out around the world that we thought,
It was like "Song to the Siren" was made like in my bedroom, and we pressed like 500 copies of it. So we never thought it would be like an issue, kind of thing. And then when it was an issue, we just changed it straight away. So you know, we didn't mean any bad blood. You know.
Yeah, that's cool. And everybody gets along. It's cool. It's a DIY ethic. It's a DIY ethic. It's great about making techno records in your bedroom. It gets back to that early punk
thing.
Totally,
man. I mean, you can just do it. That's the whole thing. You don't need, you know, any kind of support. You can just do it from yourself. If the record's strong enough to stand up, and it can stand up in a club, and people want to hear it in a club, then you can just do it yourself.
Absolutely. And that's why a lot of people say that's like the new punk.
Yeah.
Next we're going to show a video out from Butter 08, which is the band that features members of Chibo Motto and Russell Simmons of John Spencer Blues Explosion. It's from their self-titled debut album, and this is the video for Butter of 69. With a remix of the song off her album, Dilate, that's Ani DeFranco with Joyful Girl here on 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, and with me now are Ed and Tom of the Chemical Brothers. And let's talk a bit about, you've been doing a lot of remixes for people. People really like the style of remixing you've been doing. Do you take the same idea and approach you do when you were making your records, like just kind of keeping it minimal?
It's a different approach, really, because in doing that, everything's what we work towards. Like, we usually just do it in 2 days. And it's like, when we do our own records, we spend kind of weeks and months doing it. But like in a remix, it's just kind of like that, and you have to do it, and it's quite a good like kind of discipline to do.
Yeah.
But it's good fun as well, because there's not as much pressure as doing your own stuff.
Yeah, I mean, you've done Method Man, Prodigy, Charlatans, who you're friends with, and speaking of Charlatans, you did Life is Sweet with Tim Burgess, good friend of yours. It's a great song, by the way.
He's a fine man. Yeah. He's cool.
And you're a fan of the band as well, right?
Charlatans? Yeah, totally.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, stick around, because we'll be talking more with the Chemical Brothers, and right after the break, it's a brand new one from the Future Sound of London, so stay with us. Back to 120 minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield. I've been talking with Ed and Tom, better known as the Chemical Brothers. It's good to have you here. And let me say that people were really excited about Setting Sun. It entered the charts in England at number one, didn't it? Was that a trippy feeling for you guys? Were you excited about that? Or
it was pretty strange, for a record like that to do so much. Yeah, it was cool. But I suppose Noel Gallagher helped quite a lot.
tell me about your relationship with Noel. Was he a fan of the bands, or do you know him from going out and hanging out in clubs in Manchester?
When we used to DJ a lot in London, when he moved down to London, he used to come like to our club that we used to have like every week and stuff. And he's cool. We supported the band Oasis quite a lot of times.
Yeah.
And he's just, you know, he's into music and he's into doing like interesting things. And this came along, and it's like, you know.
It's very much like Tomorrow Never Knows, like the full-on Revolver, like the whole flowing trip thing that Lennon did on the end of that album. Yeah. Was that something that you, when he was doing, you saw the songs becoming, like going in that direction? Or?
It's weird, because like when we used to DJ out, we used to play a lot of like kind of heavy techno, and then coming out of that, he used to play Tomorrow Never Knows, and the place used to go kind of wild when we used to do that. And so we thought we'd try and get something that had the same kind of vibe, the same kind of that intense psychedelic kind of thing, but for a club setting.
Yeah, and it works, and it's the same kind of thing with the verses repeating. It's really cool. Tell me a bit about the new album you have coming out. What's it going to be called?
I don't know. You tell me, man.
Well, think of a good name. Well, we get the Loops of Fury EP first, right? But
It's not quite finished yet, but soon. By Christmas, it'll be finished.
And you think we'll see it in February, I think, or something like that?
Yeah, February, March. It all depends for him, you know. The sooner we get back from America, the sooner it's finished.
All right, cool. I'll let you guys leave now so you can go back and record. No, I'm sure playing it down. No, but we look forward to it. And thanks for coming by. I appreciate having you.
Cheers, yeah.
And good luck with the album when it comes out. I'm sure it'll do really well. Up next is a brand new one from the English band The Future Sound of London. You might remember Papua New Guinea. Their new album is called Dead Cities, and here's the first video off it. It's called My Kingdom. And it's new from The Future Sound of London on 120 Minutes.